I want you to listen here. These are Republican House members. These are not Democrats. These are Republican House members saying they believe over the long run the president's trustworthiness, the president's credibility. If he has issues here, it will matter somewhere else down the line when he needs some votes maybe or when we're in a big crisis. Let's listen.
I think the president, President Obama is owed an apology in that regard because if he didn't do it, we shouldn't be, reckless in accusations that he did.
A president only has so much political capital to expend and so much moral authority as well. And so anytime, your credibility takes a hit, I think it, in many ways, it weakens the office holder.
Well, if the president has evidence, I wish he would share it with us. I haven't seen evidence of mass voter fraud, and I have not seen evidence of wiretapping by President Obama.
Now, again, these are Republicans saying down the line, the president's credibility will hurt him. Is there any evidence of that today? Because we'll get to the specifics of the health care debate in a few minutes. But if you talk to people in town, they say the president, perhaps he's exaggerating his role, but the president has helped win some votes. The president has helped bring some people over on health care, that he's doing his job. He's doing what he's supposed to be doing. Is there evidence that this hurts him? Because that's the only way it's going
to
stop.
Well, let me say, concerning to me that Theresa May is the easy stuff, right? This is Britain. This is a right of center person that you can work with. And so it's like, why are we flubbing on this of all things? But as to whether it matters when it comes to convincing congresspeople and such, look, I think it remains that even though Trump acts this way, you see the polling that means that shows that Democrats are less trusted. It's like, how can these things operate at the same time? But that speaks to some leeway that he has with the American people, and that matters.
But this hasn't been tested by crisis yet. And I have to say that these Republicans who you see in these video clips saying, Obama's owed an apology or this needs to stop or whatever, they, by and large, are not trying to hurt President Trump. They might be trying to distance themselves a little bit and protect themselves. They're politicians. But
they don't have the same leeway.
But they're honestly trying to help him. When you come out publicly and you kind of say, quit doing it, they're trying to help him.
Because this also does become their problem, to your point. When they have a million reporters running up to them, asking them what they think about what the president did over and over again, they don't want to be talking about this. The other place where this might hurt him is, continue to hurt him, actually, is with the intelligence community. He hasn't had a good relationship coming into this administration with them, and this certainly doesn't help.
Well, there have been any number of occasions where we say, here's a big event that could be the page turner. It's a pretty big event when the FBI director is going to testify publicly tomorrow. And again, I think significant that the Republicans went along with that. They could have stopped this. They could have said there's no public hearing. They run the show. I think it's to the point of they're trying to help the president in an odd way. Send him a message saying, sir, see, there are consequences to your actions, maybe?
They do what they can.
They do what they can. Okay.